My name is Bob Cazet. I started Alumni Football USA right after I did my first alumni football game in 1985. Back in 1985, I just wanted to play in one more high school rules football game, and I found out that there's an awful lot of other guys that wanted to do the same thing.
On a scale of 1 to 10, my excitement for this game is probably about an 11. I'm not going to lie.
It doesn't even register. I mean, it's off the chart.
27.
I don't know, Mike. 12, 15, 20?
Probably a 12.
An 11.
Probably a 20, 30.
Game day, it'll be an 11.
About a 55.
Just over 10, I know that.
I woke up at 4 o'clock this morning.
One last time to put it to Winfield.
I'm ready to play.
I'm ready to go.
And I'm ready to get it on.
The rivalry's there. Everybody's excited.
I just feel like I'm in a regular season, like I'm back in high school.
I'm really looking forward to it. It's going to be a lot of fun.
It's all about getting out there and playing one more play. Listen to these guys while they tell you why they want to play in one more football game.
Just to leave it on the field one more time. Didn't get to go on to college, even though I could have went on to college to play ball. Had several scholarship offers, but my son was born in the year that I graduated. So I had to make a choice of either going to school and chase my dream or stay home and man up and take care of my responsibility. So that's what I did, and just stayed home and started raising my family.
It's one of those things. You go through high school, play your football. Sometimes you dread it. The last game comes around, you play that last down, you walk off the field, and you say, I wish I could go back and play one more game. That's why.
I enjoy every minute of football, you know, the band, the stands, the smell of the field, the lights, the sound of your cleats hitting the concrete. It's a little bit of everything.
I'm excited to strap up and play with all the guys that I played with in high school and bring back old memories and just go at it one more time.
I ended up not playing in college, turned down some scholarships, ended up just going to go to school. Really wanted to hit somebody ever since, so I'm looking forward to it.
Even old guys can still contribute, so I'm here to prove a point and try to walk away from it undamaged.
Just because it's a blast getting out here with the guys, just coming out and playing some football, you know, feel like a kid again.
It's more than just a game, you know, it's about pride.
Tonight we travel to a small town in Kansas. Our Kansas City is going to play Winfield alumni tonight. Our Kansas City is a city in Cowley County, Kansas, situated in the confluence of the Arkansas and Walnut Rivers in the southwestern part of the country. Our Kansas City is known as Ark City by the locals because so many people have no idea of whether they should be calling it Arkansas City or Arkansas City. So they just decide to call themselves Ark City. These two towns are typical of small towns in the Midwest. Everyone's very family oriented. Guys have their regular jobs, they work hard every day, and they all have the same small town dreams that everybody else has. One more football game. Winfield is the county seat. It's 13 miles north of Arkansas City along US 77. Arkansas City grew steadily through the latter part of the 19th century and enjoyed a population explosion starting in 1891. When thousands of people moved into the area in anticipation of the Cherokee Strip land run, it has been estimated that the population grew from 5,000 to 150,000 as a nationally hyped federal land giveaway approached and then shrank back down to 5,000 in its aftermath. Listen to one of our featured players as he tells you about the history of his town.
My name's Gage Musson. I graduated in the year 2000 and I went to school at Arkansas City High School. Yeah, Ark City has a lot of history. One thing that comes to mind is the land rush of 1893. And that's when Oklahoma was open for the white people to come and get land. So the Native Americans weren't the only ones that could live there anymore. And so, you know, hundreds of thousands of people lined up and they camped out in Ark City beforehand and lined up on the border. And when the shotgun went bang at noon that day, they ran to stake their land in Oklahoma. There was one town, I can't remember which town it was, but there was a town that had no people living in it, and it went from zero population to 10,000 in one day. I went to Oklahoma State, so I have to tell you about OU, who's, you know, we absolutely hate if you're a cowpoke. But yeah, the Sooners are the Boomer Sooners, so when the cannon went boom, the Sooners were already there, so they're basically land thieves.
Tell me what practices have been like.
So far, the practices have been just tons of fun. I mean, even if we didn't have a game, for me, it would still be worth it just because it's a blast getting out here with the guys, just coming out and playing some football, you know, feel like a kid again.
Now, what do you do for a living?
What I do for a living is I'm a wellness manager for Cowley County Community College, and I do a little personal training, and I work hard to try to generate health promotion throughout the entire college for staff and faculty.
My name is Matt Bertho. I graduated in 1996. I am playing for the Arkansas City Bulldog alumni football team.
What was your favorite high school memory?
Every Friday night was my best football memory, but what I really enjoyed was hanging out with the guys, going to Pizza Inn on Wednesday nights and Daisy Mays before the game on home games. And we would always have a dance on Friday night after the game. So you can imagine a bunch of guys that just got to play in a game having a lot of fun at the dance too.
What have you done to prepare for this alumni football game?
Me, I didn't play college football or any sports in college, so I kind of ballooned up to 270. And when I turned 30, I decided I better get working out a little bit. And so I started running every day, and then we had my first son, and then I gained all the weight back. And so the last 1,400 days or so, I've been running consecutively a mile every day outside, preferably. And then not last June, but the June before, at Cali Fitness in Winfield, they have a CrossFit gym. And I've been doing CrossFit since last June, really every day since then. So I'm back down to like 205 now, trying to get to 190. So we'll see. This helps a lot.
Okay, tell me about your family.
My family, my wife, Andrea, she actually has a book coming out, which is really exciting. It comes out August 27th, I believe, or 17th, one of those two. But it's her first novel that's coming out. It's called The Heartless City. You can pre-order on Amazon.com. we have two sons. Maximus is 5, and Leonardo, he just turned 2 months. But Andrea teaches at Ark City High School, and she's a drama teacher here. So Andrea, my wife, teaches at Ark City High School, and I teach at Winfield High School. I was fortunate enough to be on a 4-time state champion wrestling team, and I also was a state champion myself, and my brother Mark was. And so Ark City means a lot to me. And so coming out on the football field, you know, immediately I was looking for the wrestlers, and I found a couple that kind of took, you know, just started talking to and trying to encourage them to come out and keep, you know, we need you. And so the interior defense right now is state champion, second place state champion, and then a guy that didn't wrestle. So in that middle core there, it's pretty awesome.
Tell me about your job.
I am a vocal music teacher at Winfield High School. This will be my 12th year teaching. When I started the program, there was like 70 or 80 kids in the program, and now we're about at 160, 170. I was up for Grammy Teacher of the Year a couple years ago, and I made the quarterfinals out of 20-some thousand people that were applicants. There was 120 of us, I think, and I didn't make the cut to semis, but just to even be in that ballpark. I teach voice lessons to about 40 to 50 students a week during the summer. And then during the year, I teach to about 30 students a week. One of the really cool moments is one of my first voice students. I didn't to talk to you about this at all yet either. Chase Foster, he was one of my first voice students. And he is actually Nick Jonas's musical director on his national world tours right now. And he's making it pretty big. And we have some other professionals out there, Taryn Miller. Her dad, I think I did tell you this, her dad was Les Miller, that played professional football for the Chargers and the Panthers. And then Scott Fleenor's trying to make it right now. Mason Haley has a group. What's cool about the way I teach them is I take everything that I've learned here effort-wise and I apply it to the classroom, because it's no different. Sports and music, same thing. It's just about teamwork and building people up.
This is where I get to hang out.
Nice.
Yeah. And that's my state championship bracket in wrestling and my two state medals from my junior and senior year. The alumni game, you know, I mentioned, guys, we need to do Bulldog jumping jacks, we need to do the breakdowns, like we need to bring back everything we were taught. And, you know, because even in choir, we do this warm-up every day. Mm-hmm. And it changes a little bit, like you change it based on, you know, your knowledge, like you're like, oh, well, that doesn't work anymore, so scrap it. We're gonna do this new way. I have my master's. I'm a teacher. I'm a leader. Mm-hmm. I better lead.
Right.
And that's the message I sent to some of my my friends last night that were older is, guys, we have got to coach, lead. Like, because all of us aren't, we're not used to that being on
the
field.
And not just on the field, but you know, part of what this game is about, we talk about it at the end of the game, is about leading in your community.
Well, I didn't know how to do any of this. Like, middle of my junior year, I joined choir.
Yeah.
And so, like, I'll be honest, I failed theory in college twice. And I didn't give up.
Right.
And now here we are.
Yeah. Well, that's it. Persistence. It's like anything in life.
Yeah, that's what I try to tell them.
My name is James Bell, class of 99, play for Ark City, tight end.
Okay, tell me about your family.
Yeah, I'm a single parent. I've been a single parent for about 8 years, maybe 9 now. But, you know, I just keep on pushing every day and try to do what's best for my kids and keep going. I have 4 beautiful kids. 3 of them are girls. 1 of them is a boy. His name is Jay Sean. He goes to Ark City High School. He's going to be a junior this year. And I got 2 girls that live with me full time. And my other daughter, she goes to Ark City High School too. And she's going to be a junior too.
What do your kids think about you playing in this game?
He's excited for me to play. He wants to see me do something. So I always tell him I was good at football, so it's my chance to show him now.
Now, I hear you've lost a bunch of weight for this game. How much have you lost?
Well, I lost 30 pounds, and I play basketball after I get done practicing football some days, and I just stay busy and be out in the yard at work in 100 degrees cutting the grass at yard, just trying to get my body ready for this heat or whatever come Friday night.
What do you remember most about football?
Best football memory is when I missed the bus game of the week. We played Hutchinson, and I overslept, so I ran all the way to the football stadium to get my equipment, and they already had picked it up for me. And then I caught the bus halfway through Winfield and Oxford, got on the bus. Coach made me sit at the front of the bus, couldn't talk to nobody for the whole trip. Then we got to the stadium. He said, "Bell, I shouldn't play you, but we need you." So he let me play, and that was the best experience I had. I also ran almost a touchdown, got stopped on the one, and Quincy Lawler ran it in for us. At once upon a time in my life, I was a negative person, but now I'm changing my ways of being and stuff, so I just think one good deed a day is something great. It don't matter what it is. It might be opening the door, paying for somebody's drink, or just saying hello to somebody. Just as long as I can put a smile on somebody else's face, it works for me.
Now, what do you do for a living?
I'm employed at Home Lumber. I've been working there for about 5 years now. All I do is deliver houses, material for houses, anything you need for houses. We located at 1201 Main, Winfield, Kansas.
Now, when you go to work, I know the guys are talking at work. What's the talk been like at work?
He likes to play football. He wants to crack some heads, especially some Winfield heads.
Yeah, a lot of him and his buddies have been talking about it back and forth. They're excited about it. They want to take Winfield down. See what he's got left in him, I guess.
My name is Kevin McClung, class of 1989. I played as a Winfield Viking, and we got pummeled by Ark City. If it's a challenge, I'm gonna be all up for it. Earlier this year, I was in Florida. I did the Fear Factor live competition and won. So what's a little football game? So we're looking forward to it.
Tell me about your job.
In the Air Force, I was told that I can't do computer work. I was told I couldn't be a pilot. So when I got out of the Air Force, I'm now a pilot, and I opened a computer store. So here we are in my computer store that can't be done. I enjoy a lot of what I do. I'm very diverse. We spend a lot of time taking care of our customers. In this case, though, we're not going to take care of the Bulldogs like that. I make it a point to make sure my customers are happy. Bulldogs, not so much. Not this game. Sorry.
Okay, tell me about your family.
I'm married. I've been married for... Hold on, I have toes too. This will be 23 years I've been married. I have four kids. One of them's back in the back. He's somehow 6'5", and I'm 5'10". Looks a lot like the UPS guy. I also have a 21-year-old who's out on a service call. I just took a call from him. I have a daughter who's 15. She is a sophomore in the Winfield High School, and she will be there. And I have a son who is 12, and he is in 7th grade this year. So I've got four kids, all Winfield Vikings, and they're all going to be there supporting their dad.
What do your kids think about you playing in this game?
My name is Tavner McClung, and I think my dad, well, I hope he's okay in the end, but I think I'm with everyone when I say that we just want a good show, and if he gets hurt, I hope it looks cool.
I enjoy just pretty much life in general.
Okay, this I wake up terrible. And I'm running through plays in my head. I'm like, crap, I should be working on computers. I wake up and it's like, that's what I do wrong. And I'm going through my cuts, my, 9 yards, not 10. And okay, whack, all right, that's why he didn't hit me. I know he looked at me. And I'm going through all this in my head. And whether or not I actually make a difference in the game, I don't have to score. I just want to be considered. I want to contribute to our
win. Right, make a block.
And if anything else happens, that's icing on the cake.
My name is Sloan Wood. I graduated in 2005, and I'm playing for Winfield High School. Today I'm hitting the gym with my brother to work out like I normally do. I believe this prepares me to get ready for the game.
I'm excited to watch him play. I always enjoyed watching him play in high school after I graduated, make sure to come back and watch him play out on the field. Got a lot of passion for it. It'll be a good game. He's excited about it. I'm excited to go watch him.
How did this rivalry get started?
Arc City and Winfield rivalry probably goes back before I was ever born. It's just because it's two towns that are similar in size. There's 10 miles of road that separates us, and that makes for a great rivalry.
Now, what's unique about your town?
Winfield's just a great town. It's a tight-knit community. You kind of know everybody, but you don't know every single person, which is kind of a good thing, too. So it's just a good community to raise kids and, I think, have a family.
Okay, tell me about your family.
My family's all from Winfield. My dad was originally, he grew up in Arc City, he's born and raised, so unfortunately he was a Bulldog. Us kids, we all grew up in Winfield and we're true Vikings, so. I recently got married in May, happily married now, married man.
What do you remember most about football?
My best high school football memory is whooping up on Arc City every time.
My name is Brian Cazet. I'm playing for Winfield High School. I graduated 2003.
Cause I know those Winfield boys are big.
Yeah.
And they do CrossFit with me. Cause that dude, he's on Men's Fitness Magazine front page.
Oh,
yeah. I was like, oh man.
Now I know, I remember the bus rides and the things like that. What do you remember most about football?
I mean, favorite memory is playing in the rain. And back then, the field we played on was a grass field. So, I mean, things would get muddy and messy. And for some reason, rain just fires up something inside of you. And I don't know what it is, but it makes you just go wild and take off running and just tackle the shit out of somebody out of nowhere. So, that was probably my most memorable bowl games is rain games.
Now, what do you do for a living?
I own two gyms, and then I also do spokesmodel work for a company called bodybuilding.com. And then I do some magazine and model work. I was on the cover of Iron Man magazine in, May of 2013. And then I was also on the cover of Muscle and Fitness in the US, UK, Australia, 11 different countries. in May of 2014. The greatest moment of my life was when my parents could walk in the grocery store and buy a magazine with my face on it. That was unreal to me. Growing up in a small town like this, you'd never dream of doing something like that. So for me, going from small town Winfield, Kansas to being on the cover of Muscle and Fitness magazine, which was a magazine that I bought when I was a kid, and you know, somebody like The Rock was on it the month before me, and I was just like, this is crazy, this is completely surreal. So it was pretty nuts for me. I love everybody from my hometown, and town of Winfield, I mean, I moved there when I was 5 years old, and it was a great town to grow up in. Small town, yet it had its qualities, like big qualities. I mean, we had a college in it and stuff like that. We had an amazing park, and I drove my girlfriend around today and showed her different things about Winfield, and it just brought back memories for me just growing up. And, you know, like looking at the skating rink and, you know, the town pool and different things like that. So for me, it's just that hometown, small town feeling. It's great.
My name is Michael Segree, graduated in 1999, playing for the Arc City Bulldogs.
Okay, tell me about your family.
Yeah, this year my son will be a junior in high school, and he's played for the American Legion baseball team, and they just recently won state, and they traveled to North Dakota last weekend for the Nationals, and they unfortunately got beat out, but hey, they won state, and it was actually the first team to win a state championship since 1999, the year that he was born and the year that I graduated. So,
what have you done to prepare for this alumni football game?
Ever since I heard that the game was a possibility, I mean, it was kind of, people were putting stuff about Alumni Football USA on Facebook before they even contacted or seen that it was going to be a reality. And so as soon as I heard about that, I just started running, getting up in the morning, eating right. And then I found out that it was really going to happen. So, I mean, I really got serious about it. So didn't want to come out here and look bad.
What do your kids think about you playing in this game?
Oh, they're excited. I have 3 boys and 3 girls, so I mean, they're all excited. Of course, the older ones are kind of razzing me a little bit, Dad, you're gonna get hurt and all that stuff, but you know, it's just fun family talk, you know. The little ones, my little boy, he's really excited about it, so be fun to go out there and show him what Dad can do, you know. So when I was a kid, first grade and second grade, I actually played Pop Warner football for Winfield, and then my third grade year, I moved to Arc City. So I'll know several of the guys. I've actually played on the same team as those guys that we'll be playing against. So I still talk to those guys quite a bit. Actually, my best friend's from Winfield. So, I mean, there's a whole lot of trash talk going on.
On a scale of 1 to 10, what's your excitement level for this game?
Oh, on a scale of 1 to 10, it doesn't even register. I mean, it's off the charts. I mean, I've actually had a couple of dreams about it. And, man, I'll be sitting there watching TV, and I'll start daydreaming about playing, and the butterflies come and all that. So I just feel like I'm in a regular season, like I'm back in high school. So I'm ready to get this.
Now, for me, when I played in my first game, it was really hard to sleep the night before. In fact, I don't even know if I did sleep. How about you? Did you get any rest last night?
Oh, I mean, I'm going to plan on it, but it probably won't happen. Probably not. So I'll be running through plays in my head, and you know, if this happens, then I'm going to do this, and you know how it goes.
My name is Dustin Schutz. I graduated in 1998 from Arc City High School. Go Bulldogs.
What do you remember most about football?
My best football memory was probably never losing to Winfield at all. Ever. Ever, ever, ever in anything.
Now, I want to personally thank you for your military service. Tell me about your military background.
When I was in the Marine Corps, I was stationed in Washington, D.C. at the Pentagon. I was worked in the office for the Deputy Commandant for Marine Corps Aviation. I was stationed there from 1999 to 2002. As you all probably know, 2001, September 11th, the Pentagon was attacked by terrorists, and I was stationed there. I was awarded the Navy Marine Corps Medal for heroism, for helping save people.
Tell me about your job.
I work for the Department of Defense now at General Electric, and I manage on the quality assurance side all the government contracts there. So all the military helicopter engines, They come through here to get overhauled, fixed. I manage all that for the government. I'm the on-site government rep, and I just make sure that the government, the military guys and gals get a quality product.
Okay, tell me about your family.
Well, my wife, we had made an agreement that, you know, when we have one kid, you know, I worked second shift, she worked on day shift, that, you know, she would still work, I would still work. But when we had two kids, then she could stay home and raise the children and quit her job. And, well, on the sonogram, there's two kids. She rolled over and looked and said, she didn't roll over. She leaned over and looked and said, does that mean I get to quit my job? And I said, that was the deal. So 2010, my wife and I were blessed with having twins, Jackson and Carly. They're a handful. They're excited for Friday night to see Dad play football. You know, they love Bulldogs. They love Bulldog everything. They were born and raised, you know, born here, and they've grown up here. We go to football games on Friday nights. They've watched their cousin play for the last couple years for the Bulldogs, and he's going to suit up with their dad, me, one last time. So it should be fun.
On a scale of 1 to 10, what's your excitement level for this game?
My excitement level is on a scale of 1 to 10, I don't know, Mike, 12, 15, 20. One last time to put it to Winfield. I don't know how much more. The rivalry's there. You hear the guys in the background. Everybody's excited. I mean, it's game time come August 7th. And Winfield's going to roll back north with an L. And Ark City's going to put another W in the column.
I'm Chuck Rohr. I graduated 2003 from Winfield. I'll be playing center. Probably rotate around a little bit on the O-line, but I'll probably start at center. And then I'll play some defensive line as well.
Everybody thinks their rivalry is the biggest thing in the world. What's this rivalry like?
Yeah, the rivalry is pretty interesting. Married into it. But, yeah, my wife graduated in 2005 from Ark City. My family wants nothing to do with Ark City, and I've got a four-year-old son now who is wrestling for Ark City, so it's been interesting.
He'll be sitting on Ark City side with me.
On a scale of 1 to 10, what's your excitement level for this game?
Probably a 12. I woke up at 4 o'clock this morning, so I'm ready to play.
Clubber Lang said when he was fighting Rocky, his prediction for the fight was pain. What's your prediction for the game tonight?
Talk on the team, you know, we try to be humble, but we anticipate we're going to win. No problem.
Hey, why is this game so special for you?
Looking forward to just going out there with the guys. A lot of the team I played with, even in high school, and just taking it to a whole new level, see what we're physically capable of at our age.
Toe, Sal. Get that toe, baby. Long
little. Man, it hurts me just get on my elbow.
Left over right.
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
Ah!
He just killed my leg.
That's what I'm saying. That's a dunk in.
That's a good stretch. Order,
jumping
jacks.
Ready. Begin.
B-U-F-F-E-O-G-S. Bulldogs. Winfield, you ready? Get ready!
Ladies and gentlemen, good evening and welcome to Bulldog Stadium. Tonight's game features the alumni from Winfield, the Winfield Vikings.
And from our Kansas City, the Ark City Bulldogs. Alumni Football USA promotes good sportsmanship by its athletes, coaches, and fans. We request your cooperation by supporting the participants and officials in a positive manner. Thanks for coming out, and we hope you enjoyed tonight's alumni football game.
Ladies and gentlemen, now the starting lineups first.
Number 44 from 2003, Brian Cassad. Number 46 from 2005, Patrick Moore. Number 51 from 2005, Sloan Wood. Wearing number 63 from 2003, Chuck Rohr. Wearing number 89 from way back in 1989, Kevin McClung. Wearing number 8, Mr. Chelsea Ebert. Wearing number 9, Damian Lawler from 2002. And wearing number 10, Darrell Freeman. And wearing number 13, Gage Musser from the year 2000. From 2013, number 27, Harness. In 1999, number 38, Michael Sagreen. In 1999, number 40, Quincy Lowell. In 1993, number 50, Adam Mulder. In 1996, number 58, Matt Murko. In 1998, number 79, Dustin Hughes. Wearing number 88, James Bell. In 1999.
I didn't know what was going to happen. Now I'm kind of excited. We're getting ready to play. And there's quite a few guys on the sidelines. Hardly anybody's going both ways.
It looks like maybe a 3A game, doesn't it?
It looks like a college game to me. And who's number 10? He's got it in the corner.
London Proctor.
To the 5. Scoot out to the 15. To the 20. Tripped up and lands to the 25-yard line. And they fumble the ball. They just fall down. They just fell down. So first and 10 for the Vikings. They'll take over at the 25-yard line, right on it. Musson fires, and it's almost picked off, dropped. There's a handoff, and he got drilled. And they're going to roll with Musson. He's going to throw to the corner of the end zone, and that is knocked away. So third down. There's Scott Watson to get around the outside. Now he cuts straight up the middle down to about the four, so maybe so. They got half of it. That's a long ways to go. Got one back next to Morford. He's going to throw, and he does, and it's caught. Verbeck's got it to the 10, stepped by one guy out to the 12-yard line. And two guys again. Morford's going to keep it this time over the left side. A little bit of room out to the 20-yard line. And they fumbled it, and they it's still loose. Morford picked it up, and he got loose near the end zone.
Oh, he's into the end zone.
Oh, he's trouble, all kinds of trouble. Who's got it, Ark City? Yep, Bulldogs got it.
You know, Morford got into the end zone, and then he panicked, and he just threw the ball. And the ball got tipped in the air, and Ark City got it for a touchdown.
That's Casey Turnus, right, number 27?
That's two bad snaps that have really hurt the Vikings so far, Marty, because really their offense hasn't looked too shabby.
Well, they started off, they got out to the 50, and then the wheels came off. Yeah,
snap over the quarterback's head. That was another missed snap there.
Great, feels great.
It's good. It's pretty crazy. People flying around everywhere.
Real
love
deal,
it.
Right?
Yeah, it's a real deal. Love it.
I feel a lot more relaxed now. So now that I've got knocked on the ground a couple times, so I'll be ready to go.
That's my chance next. I'm going to be out there next.
We're just fighting. Trying to stay in there right now. Feels good.
And they're going to hand it off and go up the middle. A few yards on the play.
And it looked like for Winfield on the stop, Ryan Cassad.
Oh, hey, he's huge too, I heard.
Ladies and gentlemen, the rivalry between Ark City and Winfield has always been in place. Tonight, we have harmony between two members of the class of 2006 from Ark City and Winfield. Tim Cushenberry of Ark City, an Ark City alum, would like to ask Amanda Kite from Winfield to marry him. Congratulations, Tim and Amanda.
Gage Musson. Oh, yeah, it's Ark City. I was thinking, wait, that's a long pass down the sidelines and caught at the 30-yard line and knocked out of bounds. That was grabbed by Damian Lawler.
That was a nice pitch and catch there by Musson to Lawler for Ark City.
I wonder if I could still get a picture of the crowd, too. You think I'm too far away?
There are so many.
The way you pointed that out, I want everybody to see how many people are here.
It's kind of hard to capture on film, I think. On digital.
Okay.
Because also, there's folks lined up all along the fence line. There's a bunch of people back here in that great pavilion area here at the stadium.
Middle backer, whichever way he boots, that linebacker is going to get him. Middle backer's got to cover that zone, okay?
Yeah.
That's the only thing they're doing. All right? And our DNs can't get too wide because we only got four up there, so we got to start hitting that.
Yep.
All right?
Seven.
Yes, sir.
All right, that had to feel good.
It's great. Felt awesome.
Hey, what's your name?
Ready to get after more. That first hit, woo, feel some stars.
Nice white socks here for the wide receiver, and Musson looking, floating to the right, fires, and that is caught inside the 15, down to the 11-yard line. But Winfield's going to hand it off right at the middle, not much room, and fumble. I think 51 of Winfield landed on it.
If it was 51, that'd be Sloan Wood, who's a guard.
Sloan Wood!
My uncle's playing football because he played football in high school, wherever he graduated. And it's kind of fun watching.
So, second down and 10. Back to pass, and a pretty good throw over the middle.
Oh!
That's Parker Cameron. Parker Cameron with a nice pick. And that'll put the Bulldogs at first and 10 at what, the 34-yard line?
It's the overtime.
Yeah, so I came back.
Had to, there's another way to catch.
Parker Cameron's the man, the man.
Feels good, it's a great way to stay in shape.
And Ark City is winning 6-0. There's Proctor again, sweep on a pitch to the 40, a little bit of room, 35, to the 30, to the 25, 20, all the way inside of the 20 to the 17-yard line.
Boy, what a gear he's got. When he got to the outside, you saw him kicking into another gear.
Yeah, 27-yard run.
How about following, you know, Morford, our quarterback, and then Cazet as your fullback? Those are some big guys to follow.
Kid Hawkins,
Morford keeps it.
Yeah, sweeping around the outside, just trying to run man over, and he did. And he got to the 2-yard line. Who did he run into?
Parker Cameron over there.
They give up the middle, and did they get in? They got in, touchdown.
Bleachers on the other side. If you're familiar with Bulldog Stadium, it's like any bleacher in any road park. It is filled up.
Cazet did a little tumble move. Is he the one that got in the end zone?
It was one of those quick handoffs, which is Cazet did score.
He did score, okay. Bray drills one through. So it's 7-6. Winfield takes the lead by one.
By 7, Bulldogs 6.
Our halftime tonight features Mr. and Mrs. Juden, whose son was killed in combat. Listen in as Dustin Schutz honors Mr. and Mrs. Juden for their son's military service.
Tyler Juden was class of 2004 alumni. Upon graduation, he joined the Army. He was a sniper, the 82nd Airborne. Upon 2009, Tyler volunteered to go into combat in Afghanistan. He volunteered so he could be with his team of snipers, most of which he personally trained. On September 12, 2009, Tyler was killed in action. We would like to honor Tyler and present his family with this autographed helmet signed by all the players on the Arkansas City team. Arkansas City, go on. In high school, Tyler was a four-year lad in football, and he led him to track. We all know that if Tyler was still alive, he'd be playing in this game. So if everybody could stand, in the honor of Tyler Juden, Ark City alumni.
So, second down and 15, Musson under center. He's going to look to throw. Quick one out here to the outside. Freeman with a catch at the 39. Tiptoes the sideline, but he's got the catch.
High formation here for Ark City. 7-6 Winfield, early third. Musson will give it to the second man through. Jordan Field. Boy, Field's showing some quicks, and he's breaking tackles. Finally, gang tackle over the 46-yard line.
Brian Cazet is in shape. He's again in on the tackle. Morford's a tailback,
and he's giving the ball, and he's going to rumble into the end zone. Why not? Noah's done a lot of work here tonight, and he gets a touchdown for Winfield, and their lead swells to 7. Good snap, good hold. Kick is up, and that kick is banged through. 5:26 to go in the third. Winfield 14, Ark City 6. Here's a kickoff in the air, and City looking for Louisville. Winfield's special team's good, but gritting out of the pile is Freeman. Freeman to the sideline. Now he cuts it back to the inside. Freeman to the 40, dives ahead to the 44. Marty, he was bottled up at the 20, and somehow he created 24 more yards for Ark City. A little bit of movement on the line, no flag, and Miller now looking to throw a little pump fake. Now airs one towards the sideline, and that one's underthrown. Proctor's got the catch, and here comes London to the 50, to the 45, breaks a tackle, now to the 40, looking for blockers, and spins away from another tackle, and finally Proctor is driven down, but he's got the Vikings in a good field position at the Bulldog 38. Musson there, oh my goodness, maybe the second best hit of the night, and that was applied there by Garth Moon.
Ah, Garth got one.
Good rush, Garth!
Second down and 10.
And they like give it off to Freeman, trying to take it to the outside. Freeman to the 25, and he'll be bottled up. Wells to throw, a little slant. Oh, and a big hit over the middle. Good catch made by Turnus. It's Cassada up the middle. Clock running, 1:32 to go. And 89? 89's Kevin McClung.
Oh, he's in.
There he is. Here on the near side.
We mentioned the McClung, too. Not only is he a sponsor, we've known him forever.
Yeah.
And he's also 44 years old. So
he's the oldest one that we know of.
Uh-huh. He really, I mean, he's toned up, and he really had a lot of fun in practice.
And it's Matt Bertho coming out of there. He's jacked up.
Look at him.
Matt Bertho raising his arms up in the air.
Yeah.
23 seconds to go here for Arc City. They trail it by eight. They got to go a long way. This starts from their own 17. They'll swing one out here to the near side to Skylar Watson.
By both Bulldog and Viking alike. Great job, fans, for coming out.
Good job.
Good job, guys.
Yep, right here at Bulldog Stadium.
If you'd like to join in on the fun, join us at www.alumnifootballusa.com or follow us on Facebook, and you can see all the latest, greatest hits. Alumni Football USA, you better get ready. Crunch time's back.